children, today we are going to see one interesting topic. Here in military, when fights are going, sometimes they will use smoke screen. The military people, the army people will use smoke screen to move from one place to another place. Just they want to mask their place. Okay, so such time what they are using, which is used to make such thick smoke screen. Okay, the smoke will be very thick. Okay, we cannot see who is opposite side. Okay, so in military they are using that smoke screen to hide themselves to move from one place to another place. So what is in that smoke? What is in that power? What chemical is present there? Now we are going to see. And one more interesting thing also, when the ship is coming, okay, in the dark time, the night time, suppose opposite side also another ship is coming, how they will give signal to each of them, okay? So they are using this phosphine there to give signal for the approaching ship. How they are giving signal? Now we are going to see. There also we are using the same compound, phosphine only. Okay, so they will keep one perforated hole box. In that box they will keep calcium carbide and calcium phosphate. Then they will throw the container into the sea. The water will enter through this small holes. Then the calcium phosphate and calcium carbide will start to react the water. When they start to react the water, suddenly they will catch fire. First the calcium phosphate will catch fire, then continuously it will make calcium carbide also to catch fire, okay? So in that process, it produces phosphine and acetylene. This phosphine produces huge smoke and acetylene produces bright red flame. Okay, this huge smoke and bright red flame act as a signal for the approaching ship. Now we are going to see in this video.
Observe the process, how whom signal is produced and how it is used. Whom signal? This serves as a signal to the approaching ships. The containers which have a perforated bottom and a hole at the top are filled with calcium phosphide and calcium carbide. These are thrown into the sea. Water enters the container through the bottom and reacts with calcium carbide and calcium phosphide to give acetylene and phosphine. Phosphine gets ignited spontaneously as it comes in contact with air and also ignites acetylene. Thus, a bright red flame is produced, which is accompanied by huge smoke due to the burning of phosphine. This serves as a signal to the approaching ships. Calcium phosphide plus water gives phosphine plus calcium hydroxide. Calcium carbide plus water gives acetylene plus calcium hydroxide.
Water, we are seeing the fire. Okay, so how we are seeing the fire there? Because of the phosphine. In this lesson, now we are going to talk about phosphine. So what is this phosphine? What is its structure? How we can prepare this phosphine? What are the physical property, chemical property and their uses? We are going to see now. So first, the phosphine, how we can prepare the phosphine? General two methods are there. One we are getting in one form, we can get the pure phosphine. If you want to get the pure phosphine, we have to adopt one method. And another method, along with some base, we will get the phosphine. Okay, so here first one, phosphorus penetrating with alkali. Alkali, we know what is alkali? Base with water. So here sodium hydroxide reacts with water. This is alkali. Penetrating this alkali with phosphorus, we are getting sodium, hydrogen phosphide and phosphine. Okay, so here we are getting phosphine. The next method here, when calcium phosphide reacts with water. Just now we have seen in the video also, when calcium phosphide, when coming this water, it produces phosphine and calcium hydroxide. So we can prepare the phosphine like this. And another method, aluminium phosphate, calcium phosphate and aluminium phosphates are used to prepare the phosphine. When you are treating with HCl, we will get phosphine and aluminium chloride. Okay, so how we can get a pure form of phosphine mix? Here we have to take phosphorus acid. Okay, phosphorus acid. These names are important. Again and again when we repeat, it will be easy for you. When H3PO3 is phosphorus acid. Suppose the formula is H3PO4, then it is phosphoric acid. Okay. So now here phosphorus acid, when we heat, it will give phosphine and phosphoric. See, O4 is present. So O3 is phosphorus acid. H3PO4 is phosphoric acid. Okay. So when we take this phosphorus acid and when we heat, we will get phosphoric acid and phosphine. Okay. The next step, next procedure, we can take the salt of this phosphorus, the phosphine plus HCl or HCl, we will get phosphonium iodide. Okay. This phosphonium iodide, when we treat with NaOH, we will get phosphine and sodium iodide water. So they can ask in one question, how do you prepare the phosphine in pure form? Okay, in pure form they are mentioning, you must write this to preparation only. Generally they are asking how will you prepare the phosphine, you can choose any equation and write. Okay. Then physical properties of this phosphine. What are the physical properties? This phosphine is colorless. Okay, it is colorless, it doesn't have any color, but it is a poisonous gas. Then it has the smell of rotten fish smell, phosphine. Okay, so from this you can remember, okay, phosphine, fish smell, okay, rotten fish smell. Then it is slightly soluble in water. It condenses to a colorless liquid at 188 Kelvin and freezes to a solid at 139.5 Kelvin. Okay, in 1 mark they can ask what is the freezing point of this particular phosphine, like they can ask. So the smell is very, very important. Often they are asking in 1 mark. Among the following, which has rotten fish smell, like they will ask, okay, PH3, PCl3, PCl5, like they will give the option. So you have to choose it correctly. The next one here, chemical properties. What are the chemical properties? With whom it will react? What are the products we can get from this phosphine? Now we are going to see. Okay, chemical properties. First one, thermal stability. How much temperature it can hold? Okay, so here this phosphine, in the absence of air at 317 Kelvin, it produces phosphorus and hydrogen. That means it undergoes decomposition reaction. Okay, at high temperature, it undergoes decomposition and it is separated as phosphorus and hydrogen. Phosphorus separately, hydrogen separately, it is giving. The next one, combustion reaction. When phosphine, when it is coming in contact with the oxygen, okay, that means it is nothing but combustion process. In combustion process, it produces phosphorus pentoxide and water. Already I said phosphorus pentoxide formula is P2O5, but we will use the dimeric form, that is P4O10. So wherever you are seeing this P4O10, it is nothing but P2O5, which is phosphorus pentoxide. Okay, pentoxide, phosphorus pentoxide. When we treat this phosphorus pentoxide with water, we will get phosphorus acid. Okay, actually it is HPO3. This HPO3 is metaphosphoric acid. H3PO4 phosphoric acid, H3PO3 phosphorus acid, HPO3 metaphosphoric acid. Okay, so until you get into the until you memorize, repeat again and again this formula. What is HPO3? What is H3PO3? What is H3PO4? Okay, differentiate and repeat again and again, so that will be easy for you. So in 2 more questions they can ask, okay, how will you prepare metaphosphoric acid? So how we can prepare metaphosphoric acid? When phosphine reacts with oxygen, it produces phosphorus pentoxide. water there on continuous process, we will get metaphosphoric acid. See the next one, the reaction with halogen. When phosphate reacts with halogen, okay, here chlorine we are taking, we will get phosphorus pentachloride, PCl5, penta, phosphorus pentachloride and HCl. Okay, the next one here, basic nature. Here, this phosphine, it is slightly basic in nature, okay, weak base we can say. Even though it has hydrogen in it, it is not an acid. Actually, it is here, it is acting as a base. It shows weakly basic character. So, here we are taking phosphine, then we are treating with an acid. Okay, generally, we will take HCl. Here, we are taking HI. Instead of chlorine, we are taking the halogen iodine, okay, HI. So, when we treat here, we are getting the salt. When we write for ammonium, how will we write? NH4Cl. NH4Cl means what? Ammonium chloride. The same family only, no? So here, instead of nitrogen, here what is present? Phosphorus is present. So will you remember the name now? So PH4I is nothing but phosphonium iodide. Okay, this is the salt. How we got the salt? The reactions between the phosphine base and the HI acid. Okay, then here base is phosphine. So we can say phosphine is having slightly basic character. The next one, when this phosphonium iodide we treat with water. Generally when we treat the salt with water, it will dissociate, it will ionize and produce the cation and the anion. Same way here also is producing PH3 plus H3O plus and I minus is producing cation and anion. The next property here, it is reducing property. What is reducing property? When we take the salt of this salt of any metal, okay, here we are taking silver nitrate. When we take the salt of metal and treat with PH3 phosphine, it makes the particular metal to precipitate in the solution. So in which form it will precipitate? In Ag3P phosphide form, it will make a particular metal to precipitate. Okay, so this is the reducing property. They can ask you 2 more question. Give one example for the reducing property of phosphine. Like that, they can ask you. So you have to write this equation. So reducing property. The next one, it can also form coordination complex with Lewis acid. This coordination complex we are going to see in 5th lesson. Here, why it can form coordination complex means it has a lone pair of electron on it. Okay, phosphorus, it has a lone pair of electrons. We know phosphorus belongs to nitrogen family. How many valence electrons are present for them? Good, 5 valence electrons are there. In this 5 valence electrons, 3 are binded with the hydrogen. The remaining 2 present as a lone pair. Using the lone pair of electron, they can form bond with the electron deficient compounds. Okay, coordination bond. Okay, coordination covalent bond we have learned. Okay, ionic bond, covalent bond, coordination covalent bond. Like the types of bonds we have learned. No, now you can recall I think. Okay, 2 electrons will be shunned from one compound to another compound to form a bond. Such type of bonds are called as coordination bond. So this phosphine are able to form coordination bond with the electron deficient compound. Okay, yes, this so that we can say phosphine has the character of forming coordination complex with Lewis acids. Okay, Lewis acids electron deficient species. Okay, the finally uses of this phosphine. What is the use of this phosphine? It can act as a smoke screen and it is used in Holm signal. Holm signal is nothing but signal for approaching ship. Okay, during the night time, it can act as a signal for the approaching ship. Just now we have seen in the video also. Okay, children, I hope you have understood this topic, phosphine. So in phosphine, what are the things we have learned? First, phosphine. What is phosphine? Then structure. It is sp3 hybridization. Its pyramidal shape. Then preparation. How we can prepare the phosphine? How we can prepare the phosphine in pure form? Then what are the physical properties? It is poisonous gas. It has a rotten fish smell. Then it condenses to a colorless liquid at 188 Kelvin. Its freezing point is 139.5 Kelvin. Okay, these are the physical properties. And chemical properties we have seen. Its thermal stability. will react with oxygen. That is combustion reaction, then action of chlorine and reaction with the acid. Okay, that means it is acting as a base. Okay, the basic nature we have seen and reducing property finally uses. Okay, so that's all about this topic. So once you just take down the notes, copy down the notes, then you can revise, write and see again and again all the equation and close your book completely without seeing your book. Just write all the reactions. Okay. Good morning, children. Now we are going to see the remaining compounds of phosphorus. Before video, we have seen phosphine. Now we are going to see phosphorus trichloride and phosphorus pentachloride. Now, phosphorus trichloride, the formula for phosphorus trichloride is PCl3. We will sometimes write P2Cl6. It's nothing but again PCl3. Okay, so PCl3, how we can call this PCl3? First, we will see preparation. Preparation of this PCl3. This phosphorus, when it reacts with chlorine in the presence of white phosphorus, we will get PCl3. Then, when we treat the phosphorus with the thionyl chloride, what is the formula for thionyl chloride? Thio group means it is sulfur group, isn't it? So, thionyl chloride. Okay, azo means what? Nitrogen. Same way, thio means sulfur. Thionyl chloride. So, SOCl2. When we treat the phosphorus with thionyl chloride, we will get PCl3. Okay, so in general, they are asking how will you prepare PCl3 means simply we can write phosphorus plus chlorine gives PCl3. And another procedure, phosphorus plus thionyl chloride, we will get PCl3. Using these two methods, we can prepare the phosphorus trichloride. The next one here, properties. What are the properties of this PCl3? This PCl3 reacts with water and produces phosphoric acid. PCl3, when reacts with water, it produces phosphorus acid. Now tell me, what is the formula for phosphorus acid? Phosphorus acid. So it is H3PO3, phosphorus acid plus HCl. Okay. Now this equation involves in two steps. In first step, in step 1, PCl3 reacts with water and produces POHCl2+HCl. Okay, PCl3 and H2O, H and OH. See, just they are mixing together and producing the product POHCl2+HCl. This POH, we can write it as HPOCl2. When we treat it with water H2O, we will get H2PO2Cl+HCl. This H2PO2Cl, when reacts with one more mole of water, it produces H2PHO3+HCl. See, once again I will repeat. In first step, just the water, PCl3 reacts with water and produces POHCl2. This POHCl2, again it combines with water and produces H2PO2Cl. This H2PO2Cl again combines with water and produces H2PHO3. This H2PHO3 is nothing but H3PO3. It's nothing but H3PO3. What is the H3PO3? Phosphorus acid. So it involves in the steps and finally we are getting the phosphorus acid. So when we write the overall reaction, instead of writing in three steps, let us write in a single step. Okay, before in ammonia also we have done no overall reaction. Same way. Just to see here what is present, PCl3 is there. Is there any PCl3 on this side? No. Then water. How many water molecules are present here? 1, 2, 3. Is there any water molecule?
No.
Then we will get here. Oral reaction. 3H2. Here H3OCl2, H3OCl2, and H2PO2Cl, H2PO2Cl. Then what is remaining here? H2PHO3. Let me write it as HPO3 plus the remaining here, it is 3 moles of HCl. So the overall reaction is PCl3 reacts with 3 moles of water and produces H3PO3 plus 3 HCl. Okay, so this is the first property of PCl3, how it will react with water. When it reacts with water, it produces phosphorus acid. One more question. Okay, in option, they will give H3PO4 also. You have to be careful in choosing. Okay, the next one here. Similar way, here we have taken water. Instead of water, some organic compounds also we can take. For example, PCl3 reacts with ethanol, C2H5OH plus PCl3. The same reaction only in water. How we will write the water? Water H2O. H2O, how we will separate and write? HOH. See here, instead of this H place, we are having a C2H5. Okay. Now, C2H5OH reacts with PCl3 and produces the product C2H5Cl plus H3PO3. Okay, here we are getting PCl3 plus water, water HOH, isn't it? So here we are getting HCl separately, then the remaining HPO3 we are getting in same way here also. CQH5 in this part, instead of hydrogen part, CQH5 is present. This part will be produced as CQH5Cl. If you notice here, what reaction is taking place here? In organic chemistry, we have learned chlorination, bromination, iodination, sulfonation, nitration. It is nothing but the particular group will be added to the organic compound. Now, in this organic compound ethanol, what is added here? Chlorine is added. So, this reaction is nothing but chlorinating reaction. Instead of asking directly, they can ask like this also. Okay, give an example for chlorinating nature of PCl3. Okay, it's a chlorinating agent also, we can say. Okay, so we can take CH2OH. Another example here, C2H5COOH, propionic acid, when it reacts with PCl3. Now we can say, what's the reaction? Here, who is present at the H part? C2H5CO. This OH will be replaced by the chlorine. Okay, OH group is replaced by the chlorine. So we will get here C2H5COCl plus H3PO3. The reaction follows the same mechanism. Okay, then finally we will get the H3PO3 and this chlorinating compound. Okay, the next one here uses as a chlorinating agent. As I said now, chlorinating agent, and second it is used to prepare H3PO3. What is H3PO3? This phosphorus acid. So if you notice all this, what is the product finally getting? H3PO3. So these are the uses of this PCl3. Okay, so what is just we have a speaker, what is PCl3? PCl3 is phosphorus trichloride. How we can prepare this PCl3? By treating phosphorus, white phosphorus with chlorine, we will get PCl3. And when we treat the phosphorus with iodine chloride, we will get PCl3. Then property, it is the best chlorinating agent. So when we treat with water and when we treat with alcohol or acid, just the chlorine will be added to the particular organic compound, so that we will get the product with phosphorus acid. Okay, phosphorus. major products are there, so we can get phosphorus acid in every process and uses. This is a chlorinating agent and it is used to prepare phosphorus acid. The next compound is phosphorus pentachloride. This is about phosphorus trichloride. The next one is phosphorus pentachloride. What is the formula for phosphorus pentachloride? Phosphorus pentachloride is PCl5. When we treat the phosphorus trichloride with chlorine, we will get phosphorus pentachloride. Very simple. Phosphorus trichloride with chlorine, we will get phosphorus pentachloride. Then chemical properties. What are the chemical properties of this phosphorus pentachloride? This phosphorus pentachloride also is showing the same property of PCl3. This is also acting as a chlorinating agent. Okay. So when we treat with water, let us see here. But the byproduct is quite different, so you have to write carefully. PCl5 plus water, it produces PoCl3 plus 2HCl. Okay, 2HCl. This PoCl3 again when we treat with water, it produces H3PO4. If you notice in PCl3, the final product here, it is H3PO3, that is phosphorus acid. But when it is in the reaction of PCl5 with water, it leads to the product phosphoric acid. We can say this one as orthophosphoric acid also. Orthophosphoric acid. H3PO3 we got for PCl3. Now it is orthophosphoric acid we are getting for PCl5. Okay, same way for the remaining reactions, the reaction with ethanol, the reaction with propionic acid, everything is same. The final product is the chlorinating agent and PoCl3, not H3PO3 there. Okay, so that's all. Okay, the next one here, it reacts with metals like silver. Reaction with metal. Reaction to metal like silver, 2Ag plus PCl5, it gives 2AgCl plus 2PCl3. Just the chlorine is added there, AgCl. Chlorination reaction is taking place. Same way when it reacts with tin plus PCl5, it produces stannous chloride, SnCl4 plus 4PCl3. Okay, these are the reaction with metal. Okay, so the final one uses, it is used as a chlorinating agent. It is used to replace the OH group by Cl, as we seen for PCl3. Okay, I hope you have understood this PCl3 and PCl5. Just copy down and write and practice the equation again and again. These are very simple equations only. Okay, when you practice 2 or 3 times, it will easy for you. The next compound of phosphorus here we are going to say is phosphorus trioxide and phosphorus pentoxide. In this, we are not going to talk about its physical property, chemical property, uses and all. Just we are going to see the structure of this P2O5 and P2 phosphorus pentoxide and phosphorus trioxide. Okay, so let us see here. First, we are going to see phosphorus trioxide. Phosphorus trioxide is P2O3. Phosphorus trioxide. Phosphorus trioxide. In this phosphorus trioxide, just I will draw the structure. Just yourself copy down. This phosphorus are present at the corner at the back side. Okay, this is for back side representation. At the back side. Halliday said no, we will use in dimeric form only. When we write in dimeric form totally, P4 and O6, 4 phosphorus and 6 oxygen. The 4 phosphorus atoms are occupying the corners of the tetrahedron. Okay, tetrahedron. Phosphorus occupies corners of tetrahedron. Then 6 oxygen atoms are present at the edges. Okay, along the edges. Oxygen are present at the edges. Along the edges is present. Then the bond distance of phosphorus and oxygen. The bond distance of phosphorus and oxygen is 165.6 picometer. This bond length is actually shorter than normal single bond length. Why it is shorter? What is the reason? Here I will explain the reason. This reasons are not in your book. Just copy down. See, what's the atomic number for phosphorus? It is 15. When you write the electronic configuration, you will get 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p3. Okay, 10, 12, 15. Next, oxygen, atomic number 8. So here, 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. Now, if you notice here, in first shell, K shell, only S orbital is present. In L shell, S and P orbitals are present. Isn't it? In that term. Next, in M shell, that is in third shell, what are present? S, P and D orbitals are available. Now here, in this third shell, S and P are filled with electron. But who is also there? The D orbital also is there. But without electron is present. The empty orbital of D is available for phosphorus. In the case of oxygen, oxygen is 1s2 2s2 2p4. So second shell. In second shell only S and P orbitals are there. So in the P orbital, the filled P orbital of oxygen overlaps with the empty D orbital of phosphorus. Okay, overlapping is taking place. This overlapping is taking place like pi bond. Okay, lateral overlapping is taking place. Okay, so it nearly it is forming pi bond. Pi bond means what? The bond distance will be automatically reduced. Okay, because of the lateral overlapping. Okay, because of the reason only it shows shorter bond length when you are comparing the normal bond distance of single bond between phosphorus and oxygen. Okay, can you understand the reason now? What is the reason? Because of the overlapping between the pi bonds of 2p and 3d. The filled 2p orbital overlaps with the empty d orbital of phosphorus. That is the reason. Okay, the next one here, P2O5 structure. Just draw the structure, copy down. See, in each phosphorus, you have to put double bond O also. Don't forget to put that double bond O. Then the angle is here 123, here 102, here the bond length is 143 picometer, here the single bond bond length here is 160 picometer. This is also shorter than the normal bond length. Okay, the reason again it is due to the overlapping of empty d orbital of phosphorus and filled p orbital of oxygen. Okay, because of this overlapping, it leads to the formation of pi bond. Okay, pi bond means it is a double bond. Okay, another bond is forming there. Okay, so this bond will become shorter. Okay, children, now they can ask this question in 2 marks. where the oxygen is present, what is the bond length between phosphorus and oxygen, why it is shorter, you have to give the reason also. So that's all about this phosphorus compounds. In this lesson, actually we are discussing about the nitrogen family. Okay, in nitrogen family, first we have discussed how we can prepare the nitrogen. Then what are the compounds of nitrogen? We have seen ammonia and nitric acid. Now, the second element of the nitrogen family is phosphorus. In last class, we have discussed about phosphorus. What are the allotropes of phosphorus? What are the physical property, chemical property of phosphorus? In this class, we have seen all the compounds of phosphorus. Okay, phosphine and PCl3, PCl5, P2O3 and P2O5. All these compounds we have seen. Okay, in the next class, we will start with the another family, oxygen family. Okay, here till we have oxygen family and halogen family, inert gases. Okay, just we have completed only one family, nitrogen family alone we have completed. So go through this, and if you have any doubt, you can ask.